right, guys. We are back for another Dokkan Battle video. So we're in a pretty quiet period of Dokkan right now. I don't think that there's anything wrong with that. I know some people would say, like, oh, the game is dying. It's so boring and there's nothing to do. Bro, like, it's good. Like, trust me. Like, it's as the biggest Dokkan lover boy around. I mean, these periods where we could just kind of, like, chillax, we could play other games, we could go outside, you know, we could do things is good. It's good. Like, there doesn't need to be 50 red zones every celebration, right? So, we're in a little bit of a downtime. Global, I think, is going to remain with barely much until Golden Week. They're going to get the chain battle and stuff like that. Both versions, I actually probably should do a video on this specifically. Maybe I will. I mean, there's not much to make videos on right now, so... But both Global and JP are going to be on 5.19.0, which is awesome. So, you know, we're just seeing all the little puzzle pieces are just clicking boom, 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 boom for the Global sync. Like, we're getting real close now. We could easily tell that, right? So, Global, you know, is going to get whatever Golden Week is. Golden Week typically is probably going to be like the 25th or the 26th is my guess. Like, one of these 2 days is when I think the Golden Week Dual Dokkan Fest will drop. Who knows? I got no guesses. I don't know. Maybe Final Form Frieza and Kaioken Goku or something. I don't know. Who knows? We'll see. We'll see. Because Namek, we haven't had a Namek celebration since Captain Ginyu dropped after the 7th anniversary. So, it's been quite a while. So, we have server maintenance that's going to happen. Wait. Oh, okay. So we're seeing the LR tonight. Oh, shit. Okay, I thought... Okay. Wow, look at me. I'm a silly guy. I thought that the maintenance was at... Okay, the maintenance is tomorrow night. So what that means is that the data down... Or, excuse me, the LR reveal tweeted should be the 14th my time at 4 a.m. So 10 hours from now, we should see the LR tweeted. Because this will be the data download that will have the LRs and the maintenance right here. I would venture a guess that, again, we will see the LR tweeted in 10 hours. I don't think that they'll tweet it out just before the maintenance. I guess they could. Because last year, Superboo was actually tweeted at, like, the 10 p.m. Time, like, right before a data download. That did happen last year. Okay. I would expect we'll see the LR tweeted again in 10 hours from now, though. So we have that. Now it's like, what is the part 2 LR going to be? So God of Destruction Topo, very good Dokkan Fest, great Dokkan Fest, is the Dokkan Fest for the celebration. Now, my only guess is that this LR will be on this category. Now, I know immediately someone would be, look at LR Super Buu last year had nothing to do with Kale. That's true. But Super Buu was on Kale's leader skill, right? Remember, Kale was what, Universe 6 and Transformation Boost was her leader skill? Super Buu was on it. So, I think that there's one of two directions I'm expecting Dokkan to go with. I mean, it could be something random, but I would think even random would just fall into one of these two leader skills. Like, what is something super... Like, maybe Great Saiyaman 1 and 2, I could see them being, like, the part 2. This is a Yellow Coin LR, by the way. It's not a Carnival LR. This is a Yellow Coin LR that's coming that will have Pity, which is nice. Yeah, so maybe Great Saiyaman 1 and 2. What's something, like, tournament participants really out of left field they could do? I don't know. Maybe like LR Cell Jr. or something. I don't know. That would be probably like the wackiest thing they could do. Like the LR Cell Juniors would be like the craziest thing they could do. Cause I mean, they are a tournament participant character, right? So like, just to give you guys an idea, I just think that it will fall on the leader skill. Cause let's look at it. So last year, Super Buu was on Kale's leader skill. 2 years ago, Dokkan Fest Raditz and Goku and Piccolo were on the leader skill. Then 3 years ago, actually, I don't think, because it was Videl leading into Tapion and Minosha. Let me just double check. I don't think they were on Videl's leader skill, were they? I can't remember off the top of my head, though. All right, Videl. So Videl's leader skill is Defender of Justice and Pepe Gals, yeah, which these boys are not on. So that was, you know, pretty random. Although there was a lot of Wrath of Dragons stuff going on at the same time. So that is a truly kind of like, yeah, storied figure sibling bond. Like, they didn't really... That was not a good decision, by the way. This character was not a good release. No way. They could have done a lot better with this character. It's just that they're so, like, the teams they're on and stuff like that, they could be really good with their EZA now. And, I mean, they could easily EZA at any point. And Yellow Coin LRs do typically EZA very, very easily. Their active isn't really that tough. I mean, because Siblings Bond does have the best character in the game by far on it, so that helps. Well, actually, Sibling Bond also has the number 2 character in the game, too, Evolution Blue Vegeta. Okay. So, okay, 3 years ago, it had nothing to do with leader skill, but my guess is still that it's going to be on the leader skill. So I have two big guesses. I'm only going to go with two. A Jiren, Topo, and Dispo would be really, really great for Topo. This is what I want badly. Since we got the EZA Gotenks, who's good, I don't really have a problem with Gotenks at all. But, you know, Gotenks is definitely a buff for Topo's team. Gotenks doesn't need... Like, the thing that's good about Gotenks, you don't need to do anything for him, really, to be... He's just going to transform by himself. He doesn't need to stack. He doesn't need to get hit. He doesn't need to guard. He doesn't need to get orbs. Like, it's just, he is what he is, like, without any nonsense. So it makes it very easy to just throw him onto the team. So Gotenks, for that reason, I think is very good. Now, this character is pretty solid as well. But they do have one thing that can be a bit of an issue. This is not really the problem as long as you're running Topo's team. It's this right here. Another strong Universe 11 category ally would really, really, really help us. So let's hope that we could get that. I think a Jiren, Topo, and Dispo could be very fire. In terms of, like, the categories and stuff that they would have, so Universe Style Saga, Universe 11, Space Shaving Warrior, Defender of Justice, Tournament Participants. Is Dispo on bosses? No, Dispo does not get super bosses, even though he needed Ultimate Gohan and Golden Frieza combined to beat him. But he doesn't get super bosses. Damn, does that mean if they drop... Oh, that would... They couldn't do us like that, man. Could you imagine if they drop this and it's not a super bosses character? Oh, God, we would... Oh. Because super bosses... I mean, there's a night... We now have Topo, really good. LR, Ribrian, Rosie, and Kakunta are drastically improved after the 9th anniversary. Physical Giant Ribrian is a beast. Kefla is a monster, right? Like, if we got LR Jiren to EZA at some point, or potentially, you know, we get, like, this character, like, you know, Tournament of Power has a lot of the super bosses category strength right now. And I mean, it would work fine because Broly, who is probably still the best super bosses character, right? Is not a big bad bosses character. So it's like, I don't know, someone like Rosé is like cool, but the entire core of the team doesn't really have big bad bosses. That's kind of an issue for Rosé. Even Int Golden Frieza, great support and defensive character, not big bad bosses. It's just pretty much Rosé, Tech Fusion Zamasu, and EGL Fusion Zamasu. Like, I would just rather not even worry about Goku Black Fusion Zamasus at all. I'll just run none of them on the team and just build around Broly in the Tournament of Power super bosses. So this character would be good for that, but okay. Last year, at the January of 2023, Power Wishes, like, was good, a good category because it had the 8th anniversary LRs on it, but it wasn't a great category. But then every single release throughout the year was like, all right, Power Wishes, Power, like, God Goku, Bulma, like, they're all just boom, 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 Power Wishes constantly. I anticipate the same thing happening with Super Bosses this year, and we already have moved in that direction. You know, we've gotten Topo, Physical Goku Black, SDR Kefla, right? Like, we're just getting a lot of Super Bosses characters that are going to be coming, and I think it's going to continue throughout the year. So this could be a nice addition to that team as well. Jiren is so disrespected. I mean, Jiren is disrespected as a character. His legacy is disrespected. And in Dokkan currently, like, Jiren, again, like, people really try and rewrite history. Like, Jiren was not, like, the rawest bastard ever when the turn up power was ongoing. Once he got a little overly chatty, that's when people turned on him because he got a little whiny. For sure. But like this rewriting of history with Jiren, I hate it. Jiren is sick. He's raw. I would love Jiren. Jiren was once, he was the best unit in the game, right? Full power Jiren. He was in the discussion. I mean, he was in the discussion at least. So there's that. We'll see if we might see that. Now, the other thing that I think we could get is this. Now, if you look at this shot right here, this is not actually Gotenks fighting. This is Goku and Vegeta inside Boo. And then Majin Buu's memories of fighting, we see that. But what I think we could get is, so we have Super Saiyan Gotenks and Ghost. I could see us maybe getting Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks and Ghost. Maybe with that right there. I did a little bit of research, and like this right here. Now, both of these scenes, I believe, this is filler right here, right? Like this was just added by Toei, and so was this. These were both added just by Toei, right? So right here, Gotenks creates like kind of like the super ghost balloon or whatever, right? So he does this, and then they explode, and then, but it's just a bunch of Super Saiyan Gotenks ghosts, as you guys could see. So, like, right there, like, those are not Super Saiyan 3 ghosts. But, like, I could see him doing that, the balloon, Super Ghost balloon attack. Now, Gotenks, I wouldn't really have too much of an issue. I would rather we build around, you know, Topo's leaders, like, you know, kind of like the core of this team, and Topo's intro as well, which, they wouldn't be on special pose. Well, they could be. Because, like, if they had an intro where Dispo and Topo are dancing and doing their poses, and then Jiren is just standing there, like, they would probably still be on special pose, right? But Jiren is not on special pose, but he is on Defender of Justice. And then, obviously, Topo and Dispo are on special pose. But they would be on Defender of Justice regardless. So, like, I would prefer this. You guys are going to see this. Every single celebration, I want them to focus on the Dokkan Fest exclusive, the banner unit, the EZA, the LR. It should all be puzzle pieces to make the Dokkan Fest better. This bullshit, what they did with Kale is unacceptable, right? It is a character otter leader skill, but is clown shit, right? Like, no, do not do that. We want a character like this. Now, I would assume that this character would be very good. Again, this character is definitely a buff to Topo's team, right? Like the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. Like, I easily would always run this guy. And I'm sure the similar thing would happen with an LR, but I would prefer this over this. But, I mean, we'll see what we're going to get. You guys let me know what you think. So, 2023, we get Dokkan Fest Kale and Part 2 LR Super Buu. 2024, Dokkan Fest Topo and then Part 2 LR Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. Like, it does kind of fit, right? Like, oh, last year we got Boo right here, now this year we get Gotenks right here. So I could see it. And it's like Gotenks, I mean, he could get practically a full revamp. There's so many here. I should pull up just the Gotenks named characters, because Gotenks doesn't really, well, one thing people are gonna have to realize is that after the 9th anniversary ridiculous power creep, there aren't really good characters at all. But I mean, obviously Int Gotenks is very good. I mean, they're nothing. The other base Gotenks are nothing. None of the super, like this guy is okay. Like, I saw people raging about this Gotenks. He's okay. Like, he's not the worst. He's okay. He's runnable, but, I mean, it can be scary. The Gotenks' ghost is nothing. These guys are obviously nothing. Yeah, Gotenks has nothing besides the EZA we just got. I do hold out hope. There's an outside chance maybe this guy will super EZA. I think them giving him a super EZA and then releasing this as the LR would be awesome. Because then, you know, we can get another Gotenks. Would still be a buff for the team. But then, you know, we've got this going on, so let me know what you guys think about the Part 2 LR. Again, we should see it in about 10 hours. Thanks, guys, for watching, and I'll catch y'all next time.